Hello everyone. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to another edition of Insta Live with Fastened Up. Today, continuing with our array of fitness trainers, we have another interesting personality, Sameer Jawhara, who is a celebrity fitness trainer joining us from Mumbai. Let me first take him in and we can continue this conversation. Adding Sameer in. We're waiting for Sameer. So it has been a fantastic week for us, and we are presently Sameer joining us. Hi Sameer, how are you? Can you hear me? I believe we have some audio issues with Sameer. We are trying to get him back. Fitness trainer and nutritionist from Mumbai. We're trying to fix that problem. So we had this week on Monday and Wednesday, two people, Manikandan from Chennai, and on Wednesday we had Deepthi Akki, and today we have Sameer Jawhara, who has trained a lot of celebrities and Bollywood stars, joining us. So let me try and add him in back. Can I also request some of my teammates to see if there's any problem with him? Aditya? So let me see if Sameer is online. So Sameer has had a fantastic clientele, Farhan Akhtar being one of them. He has been working with many of these film stars, and it'll be interesting to see what he has to say about training these people. So he is going to shortly join with us. It's sometimes been a problem for us doing these Insta lives because there's so many people joining or using the bandwidth, and sometimes things do go a little bit haywire, but we always try and bring them back. I guess with Sameer, that's one of the problems we are facing. He should be joining us anytime now. Let me see if he's online. So I guess we still have some problems. So what we can do is I'll just log out, join in once he's ready to join. In that way, we are back live with you and continue the conversation. Okay, so I just got information that he's getting back. So just to talk about these Insta Live sessions, we are talking about specific people, diverse set of people, talking about what they do, learning from them. These are very small half an hour capsules that we have. On Monday, we have Saurabh Verma, who is a top 30-35 world badminton player, joining us. Then we have next Wednesday, I believe, Anuja Pandit, who is going to join us. She's a physio, but we'll be talking more about training teenagers and adolescents. I think he's back. Let's see if he's audible right now. So let me join. Get him in.
Hi, Vijay. How are you? Sorry, yeah, there was some issue with the internet, man.
No problem. I mean, happy to have you here because I think a lot of people were waiting for listening to you. So yeah. Right now,
how are you doing?
Yeah, doing good. So how is lockdown happening, and what's happening with
everybody,
you?
Everybody, I think I would say everybody should stay at home and be safe right now. That's good for everybody and the country also. Yeah.
Do you still work out?
I do work out. Yeah. I do work out. Yeah. 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 Whatever dumbbells and all that, but I do work out. Yeah.
Okay. So let us start.
I'm making the best of what I got at home, man. Some TheraBands, some dumbbells.
No, that's interesting. I think
I'm making the best.
Trying to understand what you do. Yeah. So let us deep dive into some of the questions that we have for you today.
Please. So Sameer, just to
introduce you to everyone, everyone knows you as a very passionate fitness trainer, nutritionist, and that too, training a lot of celebrities, Bollywood stars, and I think everyone knows the fantastic journey that you have had, but I think it will also be a time for you to just look back and tell everyone, where did you start, and did this training celebrities, was it a natural progression or what happened?
No, I wouldn't say that. Celebrity training came in about 16 years back. Now, I'll tell you how it all started. I was staying in the same building as Manoj Bajpayee was staying. And he would see me with my bag in and out of the building. And he used to keep wondering, where the hell am I going at odd hours. He couldn't fathom that I was going to the gym 3 or 4 times a day. Uh-huh. So I bumped into him once in the lift, and he asked me, what do you do, yaar? I'm very curious. I see you. Do you go to work out 4 times a day? I said, no, sir, I don't go work out 4 days. I train people. So he said, what is this training? I've not never heard. I mean, if you talk about 16 years back, personal training was something that people had not much heard. So yeah. I said, dude, basically the whole thing is a personal trainer. I said, what is this personal trainer? He's a guy who takes you through exercise forms and who takes you through an exercise program and guides you in nutrition. Mm-hmm. So he was like pretty shocked, yeah, that I got this like a very odd job that he never heard about. Okay. And so he asked me, what if I want to get trained by you? How would this go about? I said, you need a place to train. So he said, I have a room. I'm staying in this 2-bedroom apartment. And would you like to come and see it? So I went and checked his place out. Like a 1-bedroom was totally empty. Mm-hmm. So he said, could you do something? Could we fix up something here? I said, you could get a bench press, you could get some barbells and dumbbells. That's all you need. You don't need much fancy equipment, and we can start off. Because since he had never trained very seriously, sure. So it's very new to him also. So I said, that's the only thing that you need right now. You don't need to go into a fancy gym, because let's start with your foundation building exercises, which is very like squats and military pressing and all that we'll do, bench pressing and all. We'll take it from there. Sure. So I started training him. And that's how it started. But basically, the chain started from him. So he introduced me to Ram Gopal Varma. And then from Ram Gopal Varma, I went to Farheen Khan, then Urmila Matondkar. So this is how the chain kept growing. And you need to understand one thing, that you need to do good work also. It's not just because I trained a celebrity is going to call me. You need to do good work. And my funder of life has been that every client that I take on, whether he's my next door neighbor or a celebrity, all of them are my celebrities. Yeah. So I take that as work, that every client of mine, whoever, whichever walk of life he comes in, not necessarily he has to be an actor. He can be a lawyer also. He can be a businessman also. But they're all celebrities to me. Yeah. This is how the chain kept going bigger and bigger and bigger. Yeah. My life actually changed about 2003 when I did Bhag Milka Bhag. That was a total turnover in my life where fitness is concerned.
We will talk about that in a while. But one of the questions
that everyone... Manoj Bajpayee was actually my first celebrity client.
Fantastic. So that indirectly you answered that question. So Manoj Bajpayee, everyone knows, is a fantastic actor. But obviously we also now get to hear about his fitness side of things.
Right.
The other question that a lot of people would have is when you train celebrities, is that specifically, do they look out for something? Is it a general thing that they look out for?
If a celebrity who's just trying to be fit, it's a different kind of training. If a celebrity is trying to get into a film, he's trying to get a look for a film, then it's totally very different. I normally work is I read the script first. I understand either by the director or the actor what the actor wants in that film. There could be 2 or 3 different changes with the entire film. So I break down the look which has to be during which period. You can't keep the guy 10% body fat all throughout. I mean, he's got to act also. It's like a 10, 12 hours of work. So you break it down. When he has to look his best, you make him look his best. When he has to get eased off, you just ease him off a bit. Give him some carbs to eat, ease him off a bit. Because we see the end product. Let me share something with you. It's the most toughest for the actor. I'm giving him a low carb diet and salt is less. And he's shooting 10 hours in the hot sun. Plus he's getting up in the morning and training. Plus, he's training during locations, pumping him up before every shot. So it's quite tiring. It's not easy work for the actor. So the toughest work is for the actor. So you need to break everything down. What the guy has to look when at his best. This is how the breakdowns are made. Yeah, a lot of prep goes involved. A lot of prep of it goes. Like I said, I keep talking about Bhag Milka Bhag because that has been before when I got into the project of Bhag Milka Bhag. I did a lot of research on 400 meter athletes, 200 meter athletes, 100 meter, what their body language is, how they look. So, basis of that, we needed to create Farhan Akhtar into that. So, I did a lot of homework on this. It was not that just dumbbell uthao and let's start training and go into that. No. It's not like that. I mean, every muscle like of food and everything is monitored to the T. The water intake, your sodium levels, your potassium levels, your vitamins, your supplements, everything is monitored to the T on a daily basis. Plus, sleep is also monitored because the training is so grueling. That if a guy, I mean, you know that if a guy doesn't get proper sleep, he's not going to get his body's not going to recover. Yeah. He's not going to get results eventually. Yeah. He'll get into catabolic state. He starts going backwards there instead of going forward. Yeah.
So there are two questions.
Yeah.
So there are two questions that I want to ask you linked to this. One is, do you also act as the nutritionist while you are training the celebrity? Because food is a very important element
to
getting fitter.
Food is all planned. Right? Food is all planned depending on what the objectives of the actor is, whether he needs to go on a high protein diet, whether he needs to go on a high carb diet. All that is all planned. Again, broken down into five or six meals, what the requirement or what the actor prefers. So it's all down. Breakages are completely made. See, the nutrition plan is also completely made. Yeah.
Right. So the other question would be that, for example, if you have to train a celebrity just for a specific period of 3 months, you don't know the celebrity. You don't know what his pattern, his or her patterns have been, what his or her fitness levels have been. Is that more difficult than having...
That's not the case. That's not the case. Because when a celebrity does homework on that trainer, the trainer also does full work on the... I found out his complete background. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
If he has to be started from scratch or he hasn't worked out, then he has to go through the training program very gradually. I do the complete background checks. I make every client of mine go through a complete body blood profile before I take him on. Because you know, what I feel is I've faced a lot of issues in India. Why I'm saying this in India? Because abroad, when you work, you just keep signing up a form. Have you got diabetes? They say yes, no, yes, no. You just keep taking and take the guy's sign. But what happens in India, a lot of people lie. Like I've actually had clients not calling me back. When I've told clients that please get me a no objection certificate from your doctor that you're fit to exercise, they haven't called me ever back. So you can imagine what I was taking on. So it's just like a small certificate from the doctor saying that this guy is, because there were a couple of clients were really obese. I asked him, sir, you must be having, no, I don't have any issue. I don't have any issue. I said, sir, you have any blood pressure? No. I said, sir, looking at you, how come you have eating bad habit, this, that. I mean, that was not enough for me. So I've actually asked them to get send me like a no objection certificate from your family doctor. I said I don't want anything else. First step is to get a no objection certificate, and they never got back to me. So you can understand what I was taking on my head. Those kind of clients I was taking up on. Having a lot of issues. Yeah. So people don't talk about the issues. Like somebody's got a heart issue or a pressure problem. They think it's a taboo. Let's not talk about it. Yeah. So they need to come open and we discuss it with a trainer because he's eventually going to train. Yeah. Suppose a guy gets a heart attack on a treadmill, I'm going to be responsible for him. Now he could be having a blockage or something which I don't know, I can't see. So I made all my clients go to a complete blood profile, which I know what his internals are performing. So that's the first level.
So it's very scientifically done.
If a guy says, well, I'm not going to get it down. Like I have a lot of online training also. And these tests are quite expensive in the UK and the US.
Sure.
So I've actually not taken up those clients on unless they've not sent me their complete reports. I said, then you need to go and work with somebody else. I am not going to... No, this is a $3,000 test you're making me do. And this, I said, then when have you got the last... Have you got the latest one of 3 months? They said, no, I got it done a couple of years back. I said, that in that case, either you get the test done and work with me or go look for somebody else.
That's fantastic. So... I mean, one of the iconic movies that have ever been done in India is obviously Bhag Milka Bhag. And I think it also relates well to the Fastened Up brand because we have a lot of people, runners, who run out. People would like to listen a little bit more about this specific instance. I'm sure you did train Farhan Akhtar. Can you just speak about a little bit? And did he ever run faster?
Yes, he did. See, I'll tell you what, I'll give you when Farhan, see, when during this film, Farhan and I was doing like 3 sessions a day for training. Yes. Our first session used to be primarily running. We used to go to this Priyadarshini Park where there's a synthetic track where we hired a running coach who was teaching Farhan how to run. Yeah. So this was the first step that we did. So 5:30, I would reach his house and we would drive down. The two of us would drive down and a class would start at 6:30 in the morning. So this was like for hour and a half. He would learn the complete ABC of running and all that. So then he would come back. He would probably eat and just sleep. Then you should do like a second session and say about at like 1 o'clock or something, where it would be like a lot of stretching work, a lot of core work, stabilization work. And then in the night, I should do one session with him of strength training. And then that was the end of the day. Sleep by 10 o'clock. That was the pattern for 13 months.
Wow. Yes, 13 months.
Yeah, 13 months. The whole film from the prep stages to the shoot stages to the ending stages has taken 13 months to complete. So what you see has been done 13 months. But what you see, a lot of people don't know this, is what you see towards the end has been actually done first. So when you see when that big, great, big body of his is done in the towards the end, which we've done it first. Because when I read the script, they were giving me these very small windows for his body to turn around, which was not enough for me. So I said, you're giving me like a 4 months window in the beginning. And then you're giving me these 25 days and seeing him change his body. I said, it's not going to be possible. So it's better to do work around backwards. So get him, let's get him on the best of shape. Finish the shoot work on the best of shape. And then we break down his body into a slimmer Farhan Akhtar or a guy who's just starting out in the army. So they're basically gradual that we did. That's how we worked on it. Yeah. So we've shot the entire film backwards. Yeah.
No, it's perfect. Thanks for getting those insights. What was the lowest body fat that he went down to?
Seven. 6.8 to 7, yes. Yeah, but that was just for 2 days. Yeah.
2 days.
Yeah. It is tough. It is tough, yeah. When if you've seen the film and you remember the morph and the skipping. Where the thin becomes into big, he was like about 7%, 6.8 to 7% body fat.
But at some level, it also seems like a fitness trainer needs to have the right student for him or her to perform, right?
See, I can tell you what to do, but if you're not going to do it, I can't do it for you. That's what it is there. Yeah, I can't do it for you. It's not that simple that I wish I could train for a client and say, hey, take this bodies for you. That's not that simple. But Farhan is an excellent student. I've been working with him for 15 years now.
Wow.
I've been training him for 15 years now. Yeah. Yeah, so he's an excellent student.
Super. So, Sameer, I know that you are also having extensive experience on a lot of things. So let us talk a little bit about supplements. You know, how does supplements fit into the entire basket of your training program?
Supplements are very important, I would say. I mean, in India, normally, I'm sorry when I'm saying a thing like this, people, when they talk, they go and drink alcohol and say they are not scared about that. But the moment you tell them, have a BCAA, I have a protein supplement, they say, are liver kharab ho jayega, kidney kharab ho jayega. I mean, crap. So they should take care of, while doing other things, their liver and kidney could get spoiled. They are not by doing supplements. Yeah. So this is a very big misconception in India. The moment you start talking about supplements, they start saying, are ye kharab ho jayega, ye kharab ho jayega. So, people have now got, I mean, have or are getting educated more about supplements. But I mean, I'm talking about, let's go back 15 years back, and on the moment I would have a protein shake, and people would look at me as if I'm having cocaine or something in the gym. Yeah. I mean, people eyebrows rising up, and all that. It's been a lot of turnarounds have happened on that. That people are having a lot of supplements. I must say, you're fast enough. BCAA is fantastic. I'm using it on an everyday basis. It's one of the most good BCAA products that I've used. Yeah. So supplements very, very good. Yeah. But tell me something, Vijay, are you guys associated with this Inspire India Summit also? Or no? सर ऐसे नहीं करो, सर बेंच प्रेस ऐसे करो, ऐसे करो, ऐसे करो, भाई व्हाट आर यू डूइंग डूड, आई मीन यू डोंट इवन नो व्हेन टू इनहेल एंड एक्सहेल एंड यू टेलिंग मी हाउ टू डू इट यार, सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटिंग, एवरी एवरी गाय हु ट्रेन्स दैट थिंक्स ही इज अ ट्रेनर, ही इज अ क्वालिफाइड ट्रेनर.
Yeah,
this
yeah.
is one of the biggest mistakes every gym people you see me are there, yeah, all of them have become gurus in training, yeah,
right. So I think you need to have a certain amount of science behind everything. I mean, you should not be blindfolded to do things.
So it's very easy. I mean, you can train yourself, but if I have to train you, I have to know about training. It's as I said, it's two different ball games altogether, yeah. Training somebody and training.
Yeah. So that one or two questions which are normal for anyone, which I want to ask you. One is that when we see movie stars or celebrities, they all look tough and fit. Yeah. Right? So how easy is it for a normal, common person to get into that stage? And then I'll ask you the second question.
It's not tough. If you train sensibly and eat right, it's not tough. Right? It's honestly not tough. Yeah. It's not tough. Yeah. Let's say if you hire a personal trainer or somebody who's well informed about training and nutrition, he probably might be able to get you faster there. But if you're doing it on your own, it will be trial and error method. This is not working. Yeah. That is not working. Let's try it this way. Oh, let's try it there. Or you start Googling and getting information out. Yeah. So that might be a little slow, but eventually it does happen.
You'll get there.
You'll get there. Yeah, you'll get there. I'm honestly saying you'll get there. Yeah.
So
just have to be consistent. Just have to be consistent in training and your new thing. Yeah. I must say one thing. A lot of people train hard. I see a lot of these kids train hard, but nutrition is very bad. Yeah.
Very bad.
The partying in the night and alcohol going into your system and not following a proper. I tell these kids, yeah, that dude, if you guys follow a better nutrition, I'm telling you, you could be having great, great bodies. Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. So you just lose it all. You lose it all in nutrition. Yeah.
So Sameer,
no supplements, nothing happening here.
So Sameer, a lot of these young, I mean, I had one question which was coming up in the Insta also. A lot of young people who want to have, I mean, who are lean and who I've seen who want to put on body mass and they want muscle gainers, quick ways to get muscle, get body weight, etc. So how do they approach this?
Let me say, there's no quick way. Guys, there's no quick way to get muscle gain unless you're using anabolic steroids. There's no quick way. Mass gainers are going to make you fat, yeah. So there's a process. There's a process, yeah. There's a process. You have to be in it, yeah. There's a process. You have to be into training for quite a few times, quite a few months to see the changes, yeah. So it's a process, yeah. You can't say overnight that I'm going to get muscle. So you need to carry a certain amount of muscle maturity for your body. You have to be years into training, yeah. When you see, I have a lot of people who come up to me and say, I want a body like Farhan Akhtar, I want a body like Salman, I want a body like Hrithik Roshan. I tell them, dude, you need to understand two or three things. A, these guys have worked around for 15, 20 years. So they have the kind of muscle maturity in their body. B, they don't share the same parents as you. So you could either be better than them or you could not be there.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you don't share the same parents. Yeah. You're not genetically patterned in the same manner. Yeah. So you can't be exactly like somebody. Yeah. You could be better. I'm not saying you can't, but I'm saying you could be. You can't achieve what they've done in 20 years. You can't achieve it in 3 months' time. Yeah. So people misunderstand all that. Yeah.
So let us talk about one more thing. Like a lot of Indians are also vegetarian. And you also have an option to eat.
What are you doing? Where are you going far? I'm a vegetarian. Yeah. Where are you going far? I'm a vegetarian myself, man.
Great. So I
don't even touch eggs. Yeah. I'm 100% vegetarian. And I've seen both sides to it. I've converted about 22 years back. So I've seen both sides to it. And let me tell you, let me share something with all the viewers who are watching this. There is no difference. It's just a mental block here. It's just a mental block here. You have, you can supplement your protein intake by a lot of protein powders, a lot of vegan protein powders, or a lot of vegetarian protein powders you get nowadays. So you can supplement. It's just no difference. And I will tell you something. There is no level of my strength decreasing when I've been a vegetarian and when I was eating meat. So there's been no difference on that. Yeah. So as I said, everything is available and you can all supplement your diet. So there's this way. I have a lot of people giving this excuse. Or a body nahi bante because I'm a vegetarian. I said, dude, I've seen both sides. There's nothing like that. Yeah. There are so many vegetarian bodybuilders around the world. Yeah. There's so many vegetarian athletes around the world. Yeah. And they're all elite class. Yeah. So, I mean, if they can do it, why are you complaining? Yeah.
I think this is a fantastic insight from you, Samir. I think a lot of people may not know that maybe, I mean, you yourself have been a vegetarian. Not that...
They look at me strangely, man. They look at strangely, yeah. Trainer and vegetarian. I said, why?
No, it's amazing to hear that. We are also taking some questions from people. So if anyone has a specific question, please point it out. One other thing that I wanted to ask you, Samir, is not everyone has access to a Samir Jawhara, right? I mean, there are other cities. I mean, how do I choose my personal trainer? I mean, if I have to choose my personal trainer, how do I do that?
So you need to understand. See, I tell you what is the mistake where what a lot of personal trainers are doing is they're trying to impose on the client. You need to understand what the client needs. That is the most important thing. Sir, okay. I like big arms, so you should also have big arms. No, man, I don't want that. Understand what the client wants. You need to work around the client, not imposing that this looks good and that looks good. No, it doesn't work like that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
A client is coming to you because he wants to look the way he wants to look, not the way you want to make him look.
Sure.
So this is I see this happening. Sir, aise dekho, aise karo, arms bada lo, ye bada lo. No, bro, no, get it out. You need to understand what the client wants, man. So always work towards what the client needs, not what you think is right. Yeah.
Sure. So if I have to choose a personal trainer, I need to understand whether that person will be able to help me with that.
Understand what his qualifications are. A, how many years of personal training? You have to see his work also. What work that he's done. What work he's done. So you need to understand all that. See, it's very easy finding about somebody now. Yeah.
No, fair enough. 10
people. How qualified is so, as I tell people, I don't know, as I tell you, I'm still telling you this thing that people say, sir, we know everything. I said, dude, I'm telling you, you know everything. Hats off to you because 22 years I don't know everything, man, still.
Yeah.
Everything is evolving. Yeah.
So, Samir, I have a question related to what I think there is a Vijay Nair is asking. I would like to twist that question a little bit.
Yeah, please.
There are a lot of activities, including running, where you tend to lose muscle. There's a high muscle loss.
If you overdo it.
And also, when you age, for example, the level of muscle loss could be higher, and you need to recover back. So how do you do that?
Yeah.
How do you do that?
What is your advice? My advice to you is that if you're even a runner, you need to get into a certain amount of weight training. This is not that just because you do running only. Keep running every day. Keep running every day. No, you need to get into doing certain amount of strength training also for muscle stimulation also. So you need to have a balance. If you get into the, as I say, the over cardio junkies, where who get into the over cardio zone of training, you lose a lot of muscle mass. See, what you lose, you can't decide for that yourself. Yeah. You're losing fat also, but you're losing muscle also. It's not so easy for us to decide, let the fat get out of my body and not let the muscle go. So muscle also goes. So in time, what happens is your metabolic rate twists down and starts getting slower. People think, I'm running. But what has happened is he's lost a lot of muscle mass and his metabolic rate has even slowed down. Because the less muscle mass you carry, the slower metabolic rate, the more muscle mass you carry, the higher metabolic rate. So this is, people are not understanding things, but he's got this mental kick in his head. I'm doing one hour cardio. But dude, you're losing a lot of muscle in your body. So your muscle mass, so movement is what happens. And even if he eats a little bit, it all gets stored as fat because the metabolic rate has actually gone for a toss here. So that's what the mistake is. You need to mix and match. Even runners, I don't know, here I've not seen hardly any runners do strength training, but runners abroad and all, they do like a whole series of strength training. Maybe they break their training down into like 3 days of strength training and 3 days of running. They're just not doing 7 days of running. A, the body, if you do so much of cardio, the recovery is also very slow.
Sure.
You need to break it down into like aerobic and anaerobic activity, not just do aerobic. Yeah. So you need to have a balance of that. Plus, I don't understand this gentleman. He needs to uptake his nutrition. He needs to uptake some supplements, recovery drinks. Maybe recovery drinks. He needs to get into all that before his muscle mass to get lost.
I agree. I think we entirely agree with you because I think a lot of runners nowadays are also cognizant of the fact that they need to do strength training. Yeah. They cannot just be running. So they need to do at least 1 or 2 days of strength training, which will help them become better runners.
Yeah.
Right?
Absolutely.
So we are into the last session of our questions. So I will take one more question from one person who wants to ask you, how important are certifications when it comes to being a trainer? Because a lot of people want to be a Samir Jawhara, right? So obviously, after, I mean, you need to do a lot of other things, but what do you think about certifications?
You need a certification, yeah. You need to get into a proper course. As I said, just because you've trained yourself, don't think you become a trainer. Mm-hmm. Or if I'll ask somebody, he say that, I said, how many systems are there in your body? The guy has no answer. If I'll ask him mm-hmm. about something to do with nutrition, he has no answer. Yes, how to lift the right. dumbbell and do a barbell curl, he knows that. But that is not what the client wants. The other thing, 10 things you need to understand while training a client, you need to have the knowledge of other 10 things.
Right.
Nutrition, supplement, nutrition. What is body type is? How do I train him? Is it a different body type? How do I train him if he's ectomorph, mesomorph, or endomorph? How do I train him? Lifting the dumbbell and doing a barbell, everybody knows that. Everybody knows
right.
that.
So you need to understand
science behind training. You need to know what systems are there. All your systems are correlated to one another. If one is not performing, there's something, some issues are going to happen with your body. So you need to understand the system. Why is this happening to somebody? Like I have clients why do I put these clients go through a series of tests? They could be having hormonal issues or hormonal imbalances or thyroid issues, which I don't know. They're not going to come up and tell me, hey Sam, I got thyroid issues, man. Can you cure me? So I can catch it on the reports. That's why people go through a series of tests. Now, how do I train a thyroid patient? It's totally different. I have to put him on a diet which doesn't aggravate his thyroid. So all that. Yeah. Unless you're not certified, you're not going to understand that. Yeah.
So basically what you're saying is certification helps you to understand the science.
Yes.
Understand the science.
And you have to be passionate about what you're doing.
Passionate about.
So I have taken it to another level. I do a lot of reading. I do a lot of research work. Certificates have taken me to this level. That from my research has taken me two steps ahead. So how passionate are you about work? How much you want to find out about what is happening all around the world? That's in your hands. Yeah. So you do a lot of reading. You do a lot of research work. So I've done all that. I mean, I'm still doing it. Yeah. As I said, I still don't know. I know it all, So I'm still learning process.
Coming from you. So we go on to a quick rapid fire round where you need to just give a crisp and short answer. There are only 5 questions.
Okay.
What is your favorite supplement beside a whey protein?
Glutamine.
Any reason why glutamine is good for people? Can you just elaborate on that?
Actually, recovery is the most abundant amino acid found in the body. It is very good for recovery. Yeah.
And you believe in that? Glutamine is a good...
I have about 10 grams a day. Yeah. 5 in the morning, 5 in the evening. Yeah.
Sure. Your favorite holiday destination?
Favorite holiday destination is Singapore. Yeah.
Nice. Pull-ups or squats?
Neat and clean.
Very
pull-ups,
nice.
Pull-ups, any days. Pull-ups, yes.
Yeah. Cardio or high-intensity interval training?
High-intensity interval training.
Any day. What's your favorite dessert?
Vanilla ice cream. That's
it. Okay. Plain and simple. Right. So we have actually run out of the questions, and I think if... I will probably ask you one last question before we conclude. Samir, now people are under lockdown. It looks like we might have a period where gyms will be closed. Mm-hmm. We all will have to train inside the house. So are there any 3 exercises that you will advise normal people to do?
You could do yoga. You could do stretching for mobility. You could do freehand exercises. I mean, you don't need any equipment also. You just need your body weight. You need a small space to do it. So please, I suggest that people should do something. Yeah. You can do your squats, you can do push-ups, you can do pull-ups, you can do some kind of functional training, you can do mountain climbers. There's so much to do with your own body weight.
Sure. Mm-hmm. So that's what you suggest.
Because everybody was not prepared for such a long lockdown, so they have not been managed to get dumbbells and stuff. Yeah. So I think the best suggestion for everybody would be to do some freehand exercise. But please stretch. Please do a lot of stretching. If you know yoga, please do yoga. You could do some form of cardio. You could do skipping. You don't need to go down also to do that. You can do it in your bedroom only or doing that. So you just can manage everything here.
Great. Samir, thank you so much for being with Fastenup. And I think everyone has appreciated your time.
Please
do stay safe. And hopefully we will have more opportunities to go out and
100%.
Visit those gyms, etc. Thank you, Samir.
Take care. Thank you for your time. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thanks, viewers. Bye.
Thanks.